Hi, my name's Jordan and I've just finished my first year of medical school and going into second year. Originally I did a history degree at Birmingham. Didn't know what to do with myself. Ended up getting a graduate job in a hospital, and through this sort of gained some work experience and ended up applying to Warwick Medical School, to where I find myself now. In between finishing my history degree and coming to Warwick Medical School, I took 2 years off and got a job. So for the first year I worked at Birmingham Children's Hospital as a project support officer. This was really, really good because this let me get some first-hand experience of what it's like to work on a ward. And all the doctors and the nurses were really supportive as well, and sort of knew that I was sort of thinking about medicine, and they sort of pushed me into going to theatre and spending time shadowing the doctors on the ward and doing various things like that. So that was a fantastic experience. And as part of that as well, I actually got a chance to do some research and ended up presenting that at an international conference in Toronto, Canada, which was a fantastic experience. And then in the second year, I moved on from the Children's Hospital and went to go and work in pharmacy for a year. I sort of wanted to get a bit more frontline experience of sort of working on like more of a frontline sort of role. So I worked as a pharmacy technician, dispensing medications, chatting to patients about what medicines they might need or whatever else. And that again was a really good experience for sort of springboarding me here.
What sort of steps did you go through to essentially convince the medical school that you'd be suitable?
For me, a lot of it was to do with transferable skills. So when I was preparing for the interview, I obviously did all the research about the medical school and all those sorts of different things, and sort of gained that knowledge. But for me, I sort of tried to look at what I'd done while I was working and during my previous degree, which could sort of apply to medical school, and sort of made long lists of qualities that I thought I'd displayed doing certain different things, and sort of tried to match those to what I thought a doctor and the role of a doctor sort of entailed. And I actually found quite a lot of crossover. To my surprise, obviously not a lot of the knowledge stuff wasn't there. I'd not done it before, but a lot of the communication things, a lot of talking to people, a lot of the transferable skills like that really did actually apply to medical school. So I think because I'd reflected on that so much before I actually started the interview, when I got to the interview, actually it was fine because I just sort of I was myself. I wasn't that nervous because I'd sort of thought about it so much leading up to that, that I sort of already knew what I was going to say without having to rehearse it too much. I did quite a lot of work experience before I even thought about applying. I didn't even know that studying medicine as a graduate was a thing when I was doing my history degree. I toyed with loads of different ideas and then realised that it was. But I wanted to go into it with my eyes open in a lot of ways, so I wanted to get as much experience as I possibly could before I even thought about applying. So I did lots of different things. So I shadowed in the GP surgery for a week, which was really, really useful just because of the huge variety of patients that you see. I think I saw a lot of interesting things, but I think one of the things that really opened my eyes to what being a doctor is all about is I sat in a consultation with a gentleman who was a drug addict. I think just having a chat with him in the company of the doctors and the drug support workers really opened my eyes that actually medicine isn't just about curing people. I think that's a really important lesson to take away, in that it's not about just making a diagnosis and giving them some antibiotics. That's not really the point. I think in a lot of ways it's about getting to what makes them tick, and trying to get underneath that and trying to get them to make changes in their own life, to sort of open their eyes as to what their health is all about and how they can improve it. I think for me that really opened my eyes.
Have you found it a challenging experience coming from a non-science background?
Yeah, it definitely has. I think for me, so I'm 25 at the moment, just going into second year, and I've not really done any science since GCSE. So for me, that's 9 years. And most of the science that I did know, I've forgotten anyway, so it's completely useless. A lot of the knowledge that you do need to get is, there is a lot of it there that you expect to know in first year. But I do think it is doable. I think if you sort of are quite well self-disciplined and you sort of work through it at your own pace, I think that really does help. I think for me, just if I was unsure, just to ask. So in CBL, just to ask questions all the time, and just to say, you know, I don't understand this, guys. Can you explain it to me? Is really good. I think one of the strengths of Warwick is that in our CBL groups, we have art students, we have science students, we have students who've done various different things before. And this really does help because, for example, if I didn't understand a scientific concept, there are loads of people in my CBL who would. So that was really good just to say, I don't understand this, can you explain it to me? and everyone's so helpful as well. They're all just explaining it to you. Don't get me wrong, the amount of knowledge that you need to know is very daunting, but I think if you just take it in bite-sized chunks and just keep it as simple as you possibly can, then I think you can sort of get through it.
How is the way in which you approach studying medicine different to how you would have done it with history?
Very different. So I think for history, it's mostly to do with like reading texts and being able to analyse texts and apply those to essays, which is very, very different to medicine in a lot of ways, because a lot of the first year of medicine is rote learning lots of scientific concepts, presentations, various things like that. And that was very different for me because I've not really done any rote learning in terms of just learning facts, sitting down and learning facts for a long time, probably like since A-level pretty much. So that was a big change for me. I think, having said that, I think a lot of the things that you learn during a history degree actually you can apply to medicine. So I think dealing with uncertainty, for example. So in a history degree, there is no right answer. It's all about how you argue it, how you think about the concept, how you think around it. I think in a lot of ways, medicine is the same. So in CBL sessions, you're not provided with answers. You have to find the answers yourself. You have to deal with the uncertainty. You have to look at the evidence that's there and try and come up with ideas, with ways of arguing it. And I think in terms of being able to apply that from a history degree, actually, there is a lot that you can carry over that is useful. But as I said, there are also, it was a big change to come to medical school and have to learn a lot of the scientific concepts. But it's about combining those two things and getting the balance right, I think.
What's been your favourite part of the course so far?
There's a lot of content in first year which I haven't enjoyed. A lot of it is quite stressful. But I think the one thing that really redeemed it for me is the clinical contact that we get in first year. So a couple of times a term, we get to go to hospital, talk to patients, interview them, take histories and do examinations on them. And I think for me, I don't really enjoy learning from books that much. I found it quite difficult and quite frustrating and quite tiring. And I think having those little sessions where you actually go and speak to real patients and get to apply it all to someone's life and to someone's history and to someone's disease, I think really made it worthwhile for me.
Do you think your arts background gives you any advantage over students without one?
I think in some ways it does and in some ways it doesn't. I think in some ways it doesn't because a lot of the things that you need to learn in the first year of medical school is mostly scientific concepts that you have to get your head around. And I think people who've come from a scientific background are already an advantage in terms of getting there because they already have some of the prerequisite knowledge. And I think the way of learning science in terms of just rote learning like facts is very, very useful. For example, in anatomy, where you have to learn all of the muscles of the body, all the tendons. I think the rote learning way of doing it, scientific students tend to be quite good at. And for me, I hadn't done that for a long time, so it was quite difficult. But having said that, I think history does also give you some advantages in terms of you're able to think outside the box. Science students are a bit of a advantage because they have some of the prerequisite knowledge already in terms of the scientific concepts you have to get your head around. Having said that, I think having done an arts degree and coming from my own personal background, which is history, I think it does offer you a different skill set in terms of CBL sessions, for example. I think the science students are all really good in terms of being able to say what scientific principles are in play in a certain patient case or what might be applicable and things like that. But in terms of thinking around the question and thinking about the social aspects of what's going on with this patient, what's wrong with the patient, but also what's going on in the patient's life, I think having done a history degree, it sort of lends itself to that. I think as well, it brings a different way of thinking, so you can sort of think outside the box. So quite often in CBR sessions, we'd have sort of nailed down a diagnosis or thought we had done, and then all of a sudden I would just sort of throw a spanner in the works and say, oh, but it could be this really random thing. And actually that was quite good because people would stop and think and go, oh, but actually is it this or is it something else? And I think that sort of encouraged people to think about problems in a different way, from a more abstract angle. So I think in that way, doing a history degree has been a bit of an advantage.
Do you ever feel out of your depth? And when that happens, what can you do to sort of assuage that feeling?
Okay, I think in terms of studying medicine, I think everybody feels out of their depth sometimes. I think everybody has had moments where they've had a little bit of a difficult moment where you've done an examination of a patient and you've just forgotten to do loads of important things, or you've had a CBL session and you're just really tired and a bit worn down and you just have not had a great session. And I think everyone has those moments doing a medical degree. I think it is massively challenging. But I think the challenge is worth rising to, in terms of you'll have a difficult day where you're not on form or whatever else. Then the next day could be a great day, and you could have a great chat with a patient in hospital that could really sort of remind you why you're doing this and sort of, you know, renew that motivation, so to speak, and sort of pep you up and sort of raise your mood, make you feel better about it all.
Coming in without the science backing, have you felt adequately supported by other students in the university?
Definitely. I think I was building up in my head to be something more than it was. I was really nervous about coming from a non-science degree into doing medicine, and I was really worried that I wouldn't be able to keep up with it. And I think I did a lot of pre-reading, and actually, I think I overcooked it. I don't think I really needed to do as much pre-reading as I actually did. Because when you get here, a lot of the science that they do teach you, they start off at quite a low level and then build it up. So they don't just throw in the deep end. I mean, sometimes they do, but not in the first couple of weeks. It's quite sort of gradual, the introduction to it, which is quite nice. I think as well, the university are really aware that there are quite a few people from non-science backgrounds. So we have like Learning Medicine Week, which is the first week that we're here, and we have a lot of like basic science teaching in that week, which is definitely was really useful for me, I think. I think as well, there's one thing that's really good about Warwick is that there's a lot of extracurricular support out there. So there's a really strong tradition of like peer support. So students in second and third year will run support groups. One of those that I found really useful was the student seminar service. So two second years sit down with you once a week, and you can sort of vote for things that you want to be taught that week, and they'll go through it and they'll break it down and really sort of make sure you understand it before you move on. I found the student seminars amazing. My student seminar leaders were absolutely incredible. I don't think I would have passed first year without a student seminar. It was fantastic. As well as that, there's also a specialised non-scientist support group as well. So they organise teaching that's specifically aimed at non-scientists. And I sort of went to that quite a lot in the first term and found that really, really useful as well in terms of just like getting into basic science and the way to sort of think about it. I found that a really useful introduction to life here at Warwick.
How have you found funding the course?
Funding the course has been challenging, but I think for me, the situation that I was in, I couldn't afford to do the five-year degree on my own because you have to fund pretty much everything. So I think graduate medicine has been better in a lot of ways because your tuition fees are mostly looked after. You have to find £3,000 in your first year from your own money. But then after that, everything's funded by the NHS and student finance. So that's been fine. I worked for a couple of years between my first degree and doing medicine. So I used my savings from then, really, to pay for that. It's been quite difficult in terms of the fact that I've not been able to drive until quite recently, and a lot of my housemates did and do drive. And I think they found it more difficult having to like fund a car, pay for petrol and insurance and things like that. And in a lot of ways, you do need to be able to drive to get to most places or know somebody who does drive, because a lot of the placements are quite far away. So yeah, and that's been quite difficult for them.
What advice would you give to those coming from similar backgrounds?
What advice would I give? I would say to do as much work experience as you possibly can. I think the value of work experience before coming into medicine can't be overstated. I think the more you do, the better. Don't see it as a box ticking exercise in that you have to try and get to 70 hours and that's it, stop. I think really use your work experience as a way to inform whether it's the right thing for you, because I think medical degree is very, very, very challenging, and there will be times that you will feel like giving up and times that you feel like you want to cry. There are times that you probably will cry, but I think knowing that it's definitely what you want to do, And having that conviction will see you through those really difficult times. And I think the only way to know that it is really what you want to do for the rest of your life is by doing loads and loads of work experience.
If you could go back in time and speak to 17-year-old Jordan, what would you tell him?
It's a really interesting question. I think if I had a time machine, I'm not sure I would use it to go and give myself advice. I'd probably go and kill Hitler or something. If I was to go back in time and speak to 17-year-old me, would I tell him to do medicine? In a lot of ways, that would be the easy answer, and it probably would have saved me a lot of effort and a lot of not being sure about what I wanted to do. But I think I would have lost out on a lot of the experiences that made it worthwhile and made it the right thing for me. Doing a history degree, it might not be the most efficient way of getting to medicine. It's probably been a waste of money, to be honest. But I think it's easy to go back and say that you would want to just go straight back to the goal and that was it. But I think for me, it was a journey that it took a long time to get there. And I think 17-year-old me wouldn't be as well equipped to deal with a medical course as I am now. I think I really would have struggled more so. And I think just having that real world life experience of working for 2 years as well, I think really just stands you in really good stead for this course and for the rest of your medical career as well. Thank you for watching, guys. I hope you found this video useful for you. If you have any questions or you just want to ask me anything at all, just drop me an email and best of luck with your applications. Just know that it is definitely doable. And there are plenty of arts and non-science students here at Warwick who will be willing to support you when you get here as well.